Well, earlier I spoke to one of the peers at the centre of the allegations, Lord Mackenzie. The Sunday Times claimed he told its reporter he'd got round Parliament's rules by asking a fellow peer to host a function for one of his clients, the energy company Ivylink.
Organisation actually organised the function. It was an energy saving organisation. This company is a training organisation. I happened to be a consultant and therefore I was receiving a salary. And therefore I looked at the rules and realised that that prohibited me from getting involved. It was a non-fee paying function. Everybody came free of charge. There was no benefit, no commercial benefit at all.
It's disingenuous to say it was a non-fee paying function. You were being paid a fee by the client, Ivylink. They stood to make commercial profits from the contacts they were making there. The fact that people didn't pay to attend the function is neither here nor there. You were clearly making a profit out of something that happened in the House of Lords.
Not at all. I don't accept that for 1 minute.
Well, why were they paying you as a consultant then if it wasn't in order to organise functions like that?
Well, because I'm part of the consultancy. I mean, it's a company that does organise things like that. And clearly, I couldn't resign my consultancy just to host the thing in the House of Lords. And it seemed the obvious thing to get an independent peer who wasn't being paid in connection with this function to host it.
Why do you think they were paying you at all if it wasn't in order to organise functions like that?
Well, because they're paying me because I provide other work for them all the time. I'm involved in what Ivylink does. It's an energy conservation company, and of course I speak on their behalf. I do a whole range of things. It just happens that this was held in the House of Lords, and of course I realised that because of the rules, I couldn't host the function. So it went to an independent peer.
Which was you deliberately bending the rules? You accept that?
I accept that clearly the rules were got round, and I accept fully that clearly there's an argument for looking at the rules and probably redefining them, yes.
It's not about rewriting the rules. It's about asking members of the House of Lords to stick to the ethical standards that we expect of them and to uphold the spirit of the rules, not to go around finding clever ways of breaching them.
But any member of the public can go to a member of the House of Lords and say, look, I'm wanting to hold a function, perhaps a charity function, whatever it is, in the House of Lords. Would you kindly host it? Because you do need a member to host it. And that's what happens all the time. Perfectly normal. And that's what happened here.
If it was perfectly normal, you wouldn't have had to ask a friend to host it. You would have hosted it yourself. It's because there was a financial relationship between you and the client.
Well, I couldn't host it for that reason, exactly. Yeah.
Don't you think that you should have told them they couldn't have a function in the House of Lords at all? Because it smells bad to everybody who looks at this situation, and it brings the whole institution into disrepute when people think the members of the House of Lords are using their membership of the House to profit themselves.
Well, I deny that there was any profit from that function for me.
And you defend your actions by saying that you do know you were breaching the rules, you just weren't breaking them, that you were finding clever ways of getting around them. Do you think that's what people expect of members of the House of Lords, that they're going to find ways to fiddle the rules?
No, I don't, and I don't accept that I was fiddling the rules. I've explained that what the rules said, and I conformed to them by not hosting the function, which obviously the rules didn't allow.
The Sunday Times undercover reporters were pretending to be an entirely different potential client, and you basically boasted to them that you would get around the rules and make sure a function could be held in the House of Lords by asking a friend to host it for you.
Well, I mean, I didn't join the organisation in the end, so I think that's an interesting point you're making. But you could argue that clearly there's been a diversion to get round the rules, and I think the rules may well need to be revised or made absolutely clearer.